Welcome to Lesson 5, Level 3 of Spreadsheets for Business. In this first video of Level 3, we'll continue to build the functionality in our order form and learn several of the functions in the IS family of functions. In this revised order form, we're going to need to combine tennis balls, which have a variable pricing structure, with all of our other products that have a fixed pricing structure. Remember that our tennis balls are priced differently in that their price drops as the order amount increases. This order form will allow us to order tennis balls and fixed price items on the same order form. We have also added a column for shipping weight. We've also changed some of our customer requirements up here, and then we added a ship to state abbreviation, a shipping method, and a freight customer type. You should notice that we previously just had numbers up here for our shipping method and our customer types, but now we have the user enter in the actual text values of what we want, like truck, rail, air, or boat for the shipping method, and regular, preferred, most preferred, and uber cool for the customer types. We also have a few more sheets here along the bottom as well. The product sheet hasn't changed a whole lot, except for the fact that the price has been taken out and replaced with a price schedule. Notice there are two different types of price schedules. One refers to our fixed price items, and a two refers to our variable cost pricing for our bulk tennis balls. I've already gone ahead and named this cell range as products. To correspond to the two numbers here, we have two different pricing schedule sheets down here. Our Price Schedule 1 sheet is named Price 1 and contains our fixed cost items. Our Pricing Schedule 2 sheet contains our variable cost pricing structure, already named Price 2 for our tennis balls, and any other items that we dream up later that might be added back to our products page that might contain a 2 in this column. This discount sheet hasn't changed other than me naming the cell range discounts. We still have a shipping sheet in here, but notice that our shipping methods are no longer 1, 2, 3, or 4, but rather they now contain the text values of truck, rail, air, and boat that correspond to what the user will enter in back on the order form. Finally, we have a states sheet that lists all 50 states in column A, their abbreviation in column B, the region in column C, and the region number in column D. This sheet will allow the user to enter in a state abbreviation, and we can use this table to look up and determine what region number when we're calculating our shipping rate in a couple minutes. I've entered in some data here on our order form to work with. Let's start off by finding the description for the item number. As we've done previously, we use the Vlookup function. We'll look up the item number, and then for our table array, we go over to our products page and highlight this table, and the name of that table is automatically placed into our formula, since I named it that a couple minutes ago. Next, we want the description column, which is column number 2, and finally our range lookup. We want an exact match here, so I'll put in a false, close out our parentheses, and hit enter. That looks good, so I'll copy that formula down to all of these cells on our order form. Oh crap, we have some errors here on our order form. That just won't do. It says here that a value is not available to the formula or function. Since we don't have an item number here for these rows, our VLOOKUP function throws an NA error. We could leave this formula here, and we know that it will work whenever there's an item number, but it looks kind of sloppy, and I wouldn't want my boss to see these errors, so I need to come up with a way to make these errors go away. Time to introduce you to some new functions. Excel has 13 functions in this IS family of functions. Let me go over onto the side here, and I'll show you some of these. Equals IS, and Excel shows us 14 different functions that can help us determine if a cell or formula is in any of these situations, and returns a boolean true or false. For instance, this first isBlank function works like this. Let's run a check on our ID cell in this row to see if it's blank or not. After the is blank parentheses, I'll just click on this ID cell, close out our parentheses, and hit enter. That ID cell is blank, so this check returns a true. If I put something in here, now I get a false. Let's briefly go over these others as well. In addition to is blank, you can also see if a cell is currently throwing any of these error types. Pretty much any error type, but the dreaded NA error, by using this isError. If you also want to check if a cell is throwing the NA error, you can use the isError function, which also includes the NA error type. You can also check to see if a cell is containing an even number or an odd number, if it contains a formula, if it's a Boolean or true-false value, if the cell is currently just throwing the NA error and ignores all the other error types, if it's a non-text value, see if it's a number. This ISO weak number formula is not really an is function, so we really don't have 14 functions here, we just have 13. This function just happens to start with the letters IS, so it shows up in our list. We'll get into this isPMT function in Lesson 6, and we finally have the isReference and isText functions to see if a cell is a reference or is a chunk of text. We could use a variety of choices here to solve this NA error. isNA, isNumber to check to see if somebody put a number in here, isError, or isBlank. Just to follow along with the book, I'm going to use the isBlank for this situation. We now know that this isBlank function renders a true or false, so basically I want to make this formula into something like, if this cell is blank, then I want nothing in this cell. If it's not blank, then I want this awesome Vlookup formula to work. Sounds like an if statement to me. So in front of this Vlookup function, I want to put an if statement. Remember in our Lesson 4 skills, for the logical test, we need something that's either true or false. Well, this is where we stick in our isBlank because it renders us a true or false. And then we have that function to refer to our item number over here in column A. I'll close that parenthesis, add a comma, and use Excel's IntelliSense to tell me what it now needs. We see that we're now in the value if true section of our if statement. So if it's true that this cell is blank, what do we want to do? Well, we could put in any message that we wanted in here, but I think I just want it to be blank. So I'll put in back-to-back double quotes, and now I'll hit another comma, and we bop over here into our value if false part of the formula. This is where I want my VLOOKUP to function to bring back my product description. Now let me go to the end of this, and I'll add one more right parenthesis, so I have all my left parentheses paired with the right ones, and now I'll hit enter. This is where the book leaves off, but I want to show you one other option. This formula now checks to see if a cell is blank, but it will still throw an error if you enter in a value that's not a valid ID. Let me put an invalid number here, or even a letter, and they both throw errors. So it's better, but it's still not quite fixed. What we could do as an alternative, if we wanted to be a bit more thorough, bordering on a bit more anal retentive, then I could go to this next cell and experiment and see if this VLOOKUP formula throws an error by using the isNA function. If the cell is in an NA error state, then just bring back our empty value. If it's not, then put the same VLOOKUP formula in here. This is kind of a long and brittle formula, since if you need to alter the VLOOKUP function for any reason, you have to remember to change it in both parts of the formula, but at least I can now put in any value here, and we either get the right description or nothing. Either way is acceptable for this class, as long as everybody knows how it works. Just to keep in sync with the book, though, I'll use this isBlank and just deal with potential errors for my invalid product IDs and tell my boss it was somebody else's fault. Let me copy that formula through this entire column, and we're ready to move on to the next video.